Do you believe that this is not a real 3D? In fact, this is made from one smart object. And yes, you can update it with one single click. Also control its depth and lighting. Let's jump into Photoshop and get started. Let's start by opening the PSD file included in the video description. The download links for these three files can be found in the video description below. Just select the PSD file and open it. I created this file to save your time and allow you to focus only on creating the 3D text. You will get two backgrounds, and you can switch between them by hiding the top one like that. There's also a smart object with a text layer inside, which will be our starting point. You can open this smart object by double-clicking it like that. And there you will find the text layer. And I will explain why it's inside a smart object in the last step. Now let's close it and get back to our main document. First, select the text layer and press Ctrl and J to duplicate it. Double-click it to open its layer style. Select the gradient overlay to apply a gradient to it. Click on this reset button to bring back the Photoshop default values. Then click on this gradient bar, and let's make a gradient. Just drop some pins on the gradient bar and edit the colors to make a simple gold gradient like this one. Or just use the gradients provided in the video description. To import them, simply click on this import button, then select the gradient file and click load. Choose the gradient you like and click OK. Leave all other values at their defaults and click OK. Select the text layer again and duplicate it using Ctrl and J. Drag that duplicated layer to the top like that. Double-click it to open its layer style. And for this layer, select the stroke style. Reset to default. Then change the stroke color to D0B974. Increase the stroke size to 6 pixels and click OK to submit. Now I'd like to hide this gray color and only show the stroke. And this can be done by setting the fill 0%. By decreasing fill to 0%, the layer will be hidden, but its layer style will remain visible. Create the 3D depth. In this step, we're going to add a 3D depth to this text. I will start by hiding these two layers and apply some layer styles to the bottom one. After that, I will duplicate it several times with different dimensions to make a 3D depth. Let's see how we can do it. First, select stroke, but this time increase its size to 20 pixels. Also, change the color to D1AC65. After that, I'm going to select bevel and emboss, and let's reset it to its defaults so we can all start from the same starting point. Now from the style menu, choose stroke emboss. And this will apply the bevel and emboss to the stroke only, not the whole layer. Keep the bevel technique, smooth, and increase its depth to 50%. Also, increase the bevel size to something like 70 or 80 pixels. And I will skip this shading angle right now, as we'll get back to it later. And for the gloss contour, let's use this zigzag shape to distribute more shadows and highlights on the stroke like that. And for the highlights areas, let's change its blending mode to color dodge. This will give it a shiny look like this. And finally, let's reduce the opacity of the shadows to around 25%. And here is the result. Now I'm going to check this contour thing to increase the light distributions even more. Just change it to the same previous graph and increase the range to something like 75%. Let's take a closer look at the result. You may see these sharp lines, and you can hide them by getting back to this soften slider and increasing it to something like 3 or 4 to fade them away like that. Now click OK and let's finish this up. We will use an action to build a 3D depth with just a few clicks. Unhide the top two layers and go to Window, Actions to open the Actions panel. From this little icon, choose Load Actions. Select the action that you've just downloaded and click Load. Open the action folder and select the action itself. Now select the text layer and click on this little run icon. Click on the run icon 30 or 40 times. Each time you run the action, it duplicates the current layer and scales it down a little bit to 99.75% in both width and height. and all layers together above each other will make that 3D depth right here. Now select the bottom layer. Hold the Shift key and select the main text layer to select all of them. Press Ctrl and J to group them and change the group name to Depth. Also, while holding the Shift key, group the top two layers with a depth group. Let's give it a name and move on to the next step to add some adjustment layers. Adjustments. First, select the group and place a brightness and contrast layer on top of it. Increase contrast to 100 and decrease brightness to minus 20. Then create a clipping mask that only affects the 3D text group underneath it. Create a levels layer with a clipping mask. Change it to 25, 0.9, and 255. Finally, let's create a hue and saturation layer and also clip mask it. Decrease saturation to minus 30 and shift hue to minus 5. And here is before and after. You may notice that the gradient has become excessively dark, particularly in the middle. So I'm going to double click the gradient layer to bring up its layer style again and add a satin style from here. Simply change the color to white with a normal blending mode, 30% opacity, and adjust distance and size as you want. I really like the result at this point, but when I zoomed in, I found that the stroke is too flat and requires some styling. So I opened its layer style to add a bevel and emboss like before. After resetting to defaults, I changed its bevel style to stroke emboss, with its zigzag contour again. And finally, decrease the shadow opacity to 25% as it was too dark right there. I think it is better now. Now let's do some magic in the next step. Update the text with a single click. These smart objects were copied from one single layer, and as a result, they are now connected together. Once you update any layer of them, all smart objects will get the same update. So let's double click on any smart object thumbnail to open it. Once you're inside the smart object, you can add the text you want with any font you like. Press Ctrl and S to update the smart objects. Get back to your main document, and here we go. So whatever text you add inside the smart object will become a 3D after pressing Ctrl and S. You may notice also that the depth direction changes by changing the text position inside the smart object, and the depth is heading to the center like that. As a result, adjusting the text position inside the smart object allows you to change the 3D's direction. And yes, you can change the light direction. Just open the bevel and emboss of any layer. And inside the shading dialog box, click inside the angle circle to change the 3D lighting like that. Since Use Global Light is checked, once you update the angle in one layer, all layers will get the same update. And finally, to control the 3D length, you can hide the layers from bottom to top like that. Don't forget to save this as a PSD file from File, Save As, for any future use. And that's all for today. Drop a like if you want to help us, and subscribe for more free tutorials. Thanks for watching.